try to compute the following integral yourself first, and then you can use this video to see whether your computation is correct and whether you have included all steps. So we have the following function, z squared times e to the power 1 over z plus 1. That's the following contour, which is traversed once in positive direction. So first question, do we have any kind of singularities here? And if yes, what type of singularity? Well, the function seems nice enough, but we have to be a bit careful here. We have a 1 over z plus 1 in the exponential. So that can be a problem if z equals minus 1. And in fact, there is. If z equals minus 1, we have the power series expansion of the exponent over there. Then you see you have an infinite number of terms, 1 over z plus 1, 1 over z plus 1 squared, 1 over z plus 1 cubed, with some n factorials. So an infinite number of negative powers of z plus 1. So we have essential singularity. And what's even worse, our contour is the green one over there. And our z equals minus 1 is right within our contour. So we have to be careful here. We have an essential singularity within our contour. So that's step one. Step two, in order to compute an integral like this, we need to apply the theorem of residues. If f of z is analytic on inside a simple closed contour, then the integral equals 2 pi I times the residue, in this case in z equals minus 1, in the only singularity. So f of z is analytic apart from this one point, so we can apply the theorem of residues. Now we have to compute the residue, and z equals minus 1. We can expand the exponent, of course, like this. But then, question, do we have already the correct Lorentz series over here? Oh, here we need to be really careful. The z squared looks so innocent, but it isn't. Because you are now expanding around z equals minus 1. So you want powers of z plus 1 in your Lorentz series. And the z squared is not yet a power of z plus 1. So you have to rewrite the z squared in terms of powers of z plus 1, because you're expanding around this z minus 1. Okay, let's do that. So we have to rewrite our z squared. Well, you can write z squared as z plus 1 squared, of course, but then you have too many terms. Then you have to subtract your, if you expand, you would get z squared plus 2z plus 1, so you have to subtract those. But then you're left with a z, which is also not in terms of a power of z plus 1. No problem, you can do the same trick. You leave the z plus 1 squared, and you turn the z in the, with the minus 2 in z plus 1. But what have you done? And you have, instead of a minus 2z, you have a minus 2z minus 2. Okay, so you also have to add a plus 2. And then the minus 1 was there all the time. So now you have expanded your z squared, or you have rewritten your z squared in terms of z plus 1 squared, z plus 1, and a constant. So your whole f of z is this long expression over here, times your power series of e to the power 1 over z plus 1. And now we can evaluate what we need for the residue. We only need the 1 over z plus 1 term. So if we expand the first few terms, start with the z plus 1 squared, times 1 yields z plus 1 squared, plus 1 over 1 factorial and 1 over z plus 1 yields z plus 1, plus 1 over 2 factorial times z, 1 over z plus 1 squared yields 1 half, plus 1 over 3 factorial times 1 over z plus 1 cubed yields, together with the z plus 1 squared, 1 over 6 times 1 over z plus 1. And we have more terms, 1 over z plus 1 squared, 1 over z plus 1 cubed, but all those don't matter at all, because you only need the 1 over z plus 1 term, and we have it over here. Then we are done with this part. Then we move on to the minus 2 times z plus 1. So we copy the minus 2 over here, and then we do the same trick. We start with the first term, which gives us a 1 times z plus 1, that's this term, plus 1 over 1 factorial times 1 over z 1 over z plus 1 times the z plus 1 gives us a factor 1. Next term, 1 over 2 factorial times 1 over z plus 1 squared gives us a 1/2 times 1 over z plus 1. And then we have more terms, of course, but we can stop over here because all those other terms will be higher order. And this one is done. The last one, the 1, gives us plus 1 times, we get 1 plus 1 over z plus 1, and we can stop. We have more terms, of course, but we can stop here. And now for the residue, we only need the coefficients of the 1 over z plus 1 term. So we have a 1 over 6, we get a minus 2 times 1/2 from this one, and we get the 1 from this one. So we got 1 over 6 minus 1 plus 1 equals 1 over 6. There we have the residue. And of the second step. Well, in the third and the fourth step in contour integrals, we're doing ML estimates or we are parameterizing. We don't need that in this case. So we can immediately skip over to the last step, to the our conclusion. Our integral will be 2 pi I times 1 over 6, so pi I over 3. And let us quickly review the essential steps in this exercise. Well, first of all, you have to draw the contour and you have to identify the singularities and to notice in this case that you have an essential singularity. Then, in the second step, you use the theorem of residues, check whether the conditions are satisfied, and compute then the residue. That's quite some work in this exercise. And then you conclude, and there you have your integral.